Welcome to The Snapshot, our series examining the forces shaping and driving global commodity markets today. The deadline for the International Maritime Organization's sulfur limit for marine fuels is drawing near. From January 1st next year, the limit on the amount of sulfur in ships' fuel will drop from 3.5% to 0.5%. This will prompt big changes across oil, shipping, and the broader commodity market. Petrochemicals won't be immune to this. Stricter regulations will affect feedstock pricing and supply chain economics, with the effects rippling across the upstream and downstream parts of the sector. Starting from upstream, the industry remains divided on what impact this might have on naphtha supplies. On one hand, refiners are expected to ramp up run rates and use more light crude due to the grade's low sulfur content. That will produce higher levels of light ends products like gasoline and straight run naphtha. On the other hand, refiners trying to maximize middle distillate output will likely deliver tighter gasoline supply. Higher demand for gas oil and middle distillates is expected to divert vacuum gas oil from feeding into fluid catalytic crackers or FCCs. This is expected to lead to increased demand for straight run and heavy naphtha to compensate for the loss of FCC gasoline blending components. So the cost of production of major petrochemicals is expected to increase in 2020. A change in FCC operation can also affect propylene supplies. Here is a chart showing global propylene runs by source. In 2018, 34% of global propylene was produced from FCCs, 43% from steam crackers, and 10% from propane dehydrogenation units. Platts Analytics sees propylene run rates from FCCs declining from 2020. PDH runs, represented by the yellow line, would need to ramp up to 85% in 2020, but due to supply constraints, this might be difficult. For other petrochemicals, the effect of the IMO 2020 regulations on the supply and demand balance is expected to be small. But critically, they are expected to increase the cost of freight, and that could help to change traditionally trade flows, with sellers and buyers preferring to trade with short-haul voyages. One petrochemical product that could feel an impact is benzene. Benzene is one of the most globally traded aromatic petrochemicals and could be among the products highly affected by rising freight rates. Due to oversupply in Asia, large volumes of benzene are shipped to other regions, as you can see on your screen. By 2020, freight rates could increase by at least 50% or up to 30% due to a rise in fuel costs and other logistical factors, say market participants. The rising cost of new, lower sulfur marine fuel has created a discussion about the use of alternative fuels. One of the winners from this could be methanol. While ship owners have several options, such as the use of scrubbers or switching to LNG, interest in methanol has risen. And methanol availability is expected to increase significantly in the coming years, with capacity increasing in places such as China, the US, and Russia. Methanol has lower sulfur, nitrogen, particulate matter, and carbon emissions than gas oil-based fuels, making it compatible with the 2020 marine sulfur fuel limits. The installation of a small methanol bunkering station can cost around €400,000, and a bunker vessel could be converted to run on methanol for around €1.5 million, according to industry estimates. This compares with a bill of about €50 million to build an LNG terminal and €30 million to build a new LNG bunker barge. Something to think about for ship owners looking for a lower cost solution. How many will make the switch remains to be seen. Until next time on this Snapshot, we'll be keeping an eye on the market.